it's the third phase here, and knock on by, the Philippines scrum down Japan. So currently Japan being the ranked number one Asian sevens women's team in the region at the moment, and I'm sure this will be a great test for the Philippines to see where they are for the rest of the series. So if they can put on a good performance, I'm sure it'll lead to great things throughout the next few days. So scrum down, Japanese ball just outside the Philippines 22. Free kick, feed not straight, and let's see what these two teams are all about compared to the first two teams decided to run a bit in the first pool match. So the rain has stopped a little bit more, so Philippines have tapped and they've got a bit more confusion this time around. They've got a bit more traffic. Route one, Japanese player on the ball, tackle, not releasing, and there's the intentions by the Japanese. Nothing that I didn't expect. They were just going to have a go, and they've got pure pace right across the park. But first up, mistake there, just one simple pass and a knock on by the Japanese. And the way the seedings go in these first round pool matches, you'd hope not to see big scores with a 29-0 previous match in pool one. So eventually by day two, they end up playing against their own peer groups and playing the knockout stages, and the score becomes a lot more competitive. So I think we may be seeing some one-sided scores in our first day here at the Asian Sevens Series. So free kick to Japan. Tap straight away into their two passes out inside the Philippines 22, and 5 meters out with a tackle ball. Pick and pass, play on by the referee. Mistake there by the Japanese, and the Philippines have regathered possession. Can they get themselves outside of this hole there? They're stuck in there. The Japanese putting so much pressure on their tackle area. Just so much enough, and a big run there by the big Japanese base player. And pressure hounding on, and great facets of play by the Japanese, but take your hat off to the Philippines. That was pure determined defense by those girls there. So a knock on with a try begging for the Japanese. So 5 meter scrum, Philippine ball. And once again, similarities, but just pure power by the Japanese, and counter scrummed against the Philippine side. Turnover, one pass out, and under the post.
First try of the match, scored by Japan number 7, Chisato Yoku.
And try was scored by number 7 of the Japanese side, Chisato Yoku, by an announcement.
The conversion is good, and Japan lead by 7 points to nil.
To nil. Conversion is successful, 7 points to nil to the Philippines. To Japan. And I'm colorblind today, so Japan in the red, Philippines in the blue. Kick's gone long inside the 22. They've elected, whether that is such a word in this case, elected or just let it bounce and rolled into touch. So put pressure back onto the Philippines inside their 22 with a line out. So this is probably the first line out of the tournament, and this is only our second match. So the intentions once again is we want to keep the ball in hand and have a go. So great line out, tapped it through, but the Japanese went through and scooped it up themselves. So now they've gathered themselves at 3 meters out from the try line. Azaha from Singapore, the referee has got the indications. Plan advantage, advantages has been successful with
second
the try.
Second try for Japan, scored by number 10, Yuka Kanematsu.
Number 10, Yuka Kanematsu, and taking the score for Japan at 12 points to nil. And once again, what we're seeing is just those small little areas with teams like
and
the Philippines.
The conversion.
And I think we'll just end up becoming a very dominant one-sided performance in some of these pool matches. But it's great, I must say, it's great to see these developing nations entering these tournaments, and Philippines women's rugby has been thriving for many, 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 many years with the leadership of Matt Cullen in the Philippines.
And the score remains 12-0.
And his team is doing a fantastic job, and numbers are growing. So the only way to learn is get these girls at tournaments in play. So kickoff to Philippines by Japan with a knock on in the kickoff receive. So once again, it's just a simple fundamental mistakes, and that just comes down to experience, and that experience is the more you play, the more you learn. So here we go, Japanese inside the Philippines half with the scrum down. Great solid scrum. Nice short ball from off the scrum half, and great pace underneath the post here. What fantastic to see the
try for Japan, number 11, Mifui Koide.
And the 9 Japanese just scooped up for the base of the scrum with the 10 just punching into that hole that was created. So that was fantastic. Current score now with the try converted.
And on this occasion, the conversion is good, and Japan stretched their lead to 19 points to nil.
To Japan. Current score 19 points. Now Japan leading over the Philippines with the halftime bell yet to come. Kick's gone to the same place. Let it bounce, but it's bounced kindly into the hands. And let's see. Yes, making great yards and a great powerful run there. Recycled ball. I think referee may be playing an offside line, but he's out there. I'm not, so play on. This is exactly how they want to be playing, they're just keeping that position for longer periods of time there. And forced that bit of pressure on the Japanese. Azaha has called offside. Penalty to the Philippine national women's team. And it's lovely to see a lot more new faces than I have seen over the last few years. So it's a development program is working well for this union. So time on the clock. What are they going to do? It's a tap and go. They're doing a bit of a loop, but I'm sure it looks like they're about to loop into themselves. Playing the ball on the ground. And the Japanese sort of gave away a couple of key penalties there, but I'm sure being the score at 19 points to nil, that won't bother them leading into the half. So that's better by the Philippine side. Have a go. Keep possession. All the defenders on that ball, putting so much pressure. Where's the support players by the Philippines? Azaha's going to play that knock on. Right on the bell at halftime. So current score, Japan leading the Philippines at 19 points to nil.
Referee blows the whistle for halftime, with Japan leading the Philippines by 19 points to nil. Just about ready to start the second half. Just time to tell you that the F&B tent is now open at the training triangle. A wide range of tempting food and beverage items at surprisingly reasonable prices, including breakfast specials. Make your way to the training triangle F&B tent. Japan 19. Philippines yet to score.
The second half of the second pool match of the HSBC Asian Sevens Women's Series. And Philippines running from the left to right against Japan. National Women's Team kick long inside of the 22. Japan, great movement. Three passes and are straight outside of their 22. Regaining position. And here we go again. Just a couple more passes back out. Got big, strong runners. And great support players all over the park. So penalty against the Kazakhstan side. Against the Philippines side, offside at the contact area, and Japan tap and go again. So That's been cycled with two phases already up to the halfway. And hence a knock on by the Japanese, but it's a shame to see they had great fourth formation, great sense of awareness, but there shouldn't be any excuse because the rain has disappeared. The ball's starting to dry up a little bit, probably not as much as it was in the first half, but yeah, I think those these mistakes should be eradicated by now with the weather sort of starting to dry up. So let's hopefully that's rain has gone away. That's an interesting feed into the scrum. I think she's played a bit of basketball before. And Azaha probably confused himself. He said never seen it before, so he's going to go for a free kick. But probably not straight, so Japan on the 10-meter mark inside their own half. Tap and go, they've got a lot of width, got a lot of options. And once again, Japan putting so much pressure on themselves. And in the studio, the special guest, Aaron Stockdale, all the way from Whakatane, going to say a couple of words on the match. I think he's going to be busy, so we'll talk to him later on, our special guest. All right, scrum down for the Philippines. See if we, this half can be a totally different one from the second half. And watching this scrum half, watch the first one, she bounced it in. So it's probably a basketball player. Let's see what she can do this time around. Scrum down. Feed in. Think she's learned her lesson. And so much pressure put by the Japanese side, and Azaha's going for a knock on by the Japanese. No advantage. Played back here, scrum down again. Substitutes again being made. Scrum's gone not quite 180, but the Japanese have regathered that one there. Once again, not gone, but great pressure by the Japanese. I think the Philippines have got a great set piece of scrum there. I mean, in terms of great, they've got to hold that position for about, you know, quick feed and get it out, and number nine's just got to come around the base and clear it. There we go. That's the one. Quick feed, get it out, and move it out. Two passes again. And great turnover by the Japanese. Look at that great support from the inside. She had runners inside, outside. And that's what the difference is between some of these teams that have been playing at this level for such a long, long, long time. But you got to take your hats off to the Philippine
try
side. They had
for Japan,
so
number five, scored by Yuki Sue, 24-0.
Do anything
Japan
with it.
Lead
so
the Philippines.
Try, converted, takes the score out to 26 points to nil. Japan over the Philippines. Great kickoff and great receive there by the Philippines. That's better formation by them. Clear that ball out, and the Japanese player's on top. No, she's off her feet. So it's a tap and go. Well done, the Philippines. But where's her support? She's going to get tackled, and here comes that second bite of the cherry by the Japanese. So way they've go, position in hand. You just can't afford to be isolated. So, and here they're going wide, and there we go. Just going to give it just pure speed, inside pass support. And that's what it's all about. Numbers on the game here. Numbers on the ball. Options inside, outside. And before you know, try time.
Try time for number four, Ano Kuwai.
And try time by number four of the Japanese team, Ano Kuwai. Takes that current score to 31 points to nil. And as indicated early on, we're going to see a few little lopsided, one lopsided scores this morning on day one. And that sort of gives you a bit of an
the
indication
conversion attempt
on
from Yuki Sui goes
how the pool
wide.
Will,
Japan
seed
31.
Day two for knockouts.
So yet to score.
And quick kickoff. Try was unconverted. Current score 31 points to nil. And intentions was by the Japanese is take it to the far side with no Philippine players out there, and put pressure on them, which they had. So Philippines not gone. Scrum to the Japanese side outside, just outside of the 22. And here we go, got great by the Japanese team. It's at number 9, looking quite elusive with that pick off the base of the scrum and sucking in that first defender from the Philippines, and all of a sudden let the ball do the work and support players, runners
in the
side.
Japan number 11, Mifuyu Koide.
National women's side. So at the moment, current women's Asian champions are heading out to a big score against the so-called newly developed Philippines team. So try unconverted, 36 points to nil to the Japan.
Conversion is short. Japan lead 36-0.
Clock's ticking away against the Philippines. I'm sure the coaching staff of the whole squad of Matt Cullen and his team will look back at this one and realise, okay, there's a little bit more work on just the simple fundamentals. So one kick off there, Philippines decided just to let that one bounce once again. So the whole scenario was you just can't let the ball bounce in the game of sevens, especially in conditions like this today. So playing advantage by Azaha from Singapore. It's a great pass, a cut-out pass to Japan wide out, and just the Philippines are just not holding on to that ball. When they do, they just get turned over, and just possibly just the experience that
another
they don't try
have. For Japan number 4, Ano Kuwai.
And the second try for Japan, Ano
takes
Kuwai.
Japan up to 41.
They've got great support. So what we're seeing between the two teams, one team are struggling to hold on position, while the other team have got lots of options and support players on the inside outside. So with the try
and converted the conversion by the from Japanese, number 11, the Mifuyu Koide is good. The referee blows for full time, and Japan win over the Philippines by 43 points to nil.
Of day one. Number And don't forget, this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, you're here for the Asian Sevens Series held at Hong Kong Football Club at Sports Road here in Hong Kong. And if you are streamlining, hook up to the game, the big game this afternoon, the All Blacks versus the Wallabies at 3:30 kickoff. And if you're coming out of the stadium, got a spare latte coffee, there's four of us in the commentary box. Don't be afraid to bring one on up.